Hello. Welcome or welcome back to TSC Talks, the podcast where we talk about tuberous sclerosis complex and other related issues. My name's Jill Woodworth, and I am your host. On today's podcast, we went a little bit TSC light with my guest, Alex Skuby, the actor who was recently a co-host for Comedy for a Cure, the TS Alliance fundraiser in LA, which we discuss in the podcast. He's hosted it for, I believe, the last 6 years, and he got into hosting it through his wife, who is an accomplished actress herself on Fear the Walking Dead and many other things. You might know Alex from, well, I knew him from King of Queens, where he played Carrie's boss, Doug. And Doug was a real, I'm not going to swear because I already have gotten this podcast episode an explicit rating. We cut out a lot of the subject material. It really wasn't that bad, but I don't want to go. I had to be honest and put it on iTunes with explicit. So it's the first one that I've rated that way. And I think you'll enjoy the conversation we had. We talk about, you know, good habits, bad habits, just keeping on, the Hollywood business, the highs and the lows. He talks about his process as an actor and just why he loves acting and how he kind of fell into it, didn't really set out on that career path, and his new podcast that he's doing called Alex Skuby Podcast, I believe, and it is light love and a little bit of anger. So it's interesting to talk to another podcaster, and I don't want to keep re-recording this intro. I don't want to flub it. I want to give him all the credit for just being willing to, you know, there was no ego here, and I just felt like I was talking to anybody on the street. I find comedians fascinating overall, and so I have always been a fan of, you know, Joe Rogan and other podcaster comedians. So I thought Alex was great. I hope you guys enjoy it. He really had a lot of great things to say about the TS Alliance and how he got involved and the people that he's met and how he, you know, just feels a sense of, you know, real peace and fulfillment being involved with us all. So that's a credit to our community. And I'm going to really stop talking because I think you'd rather hear from Alex. So again, Alex Skuby, accomplished Hollywood actor on TSC Talks. Go listen to Alex. Add the Alex Skuby podcast, and I'll put all his links up, and going to stop now. Take it away. Thanks again. Take it away, Alex.
Thanks for being on my podcast. And
yeah, of course.
If you want to just tell me a little bit about yourself, give me a little history. I've read a little bit about you, and I've listened to your podcast.
That's new for me, by the way.
Oh, they were great. They were so funny. I was laughing.
You know, the funny thing is I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm just kind of just talking, and then I go like, okay, I guess that's enough, and then I end it. I mean,
well, it's funny because that's what I started doing, and like I started it with my kids, and then I went and I think I talked a couple times, and then I had the idea of starting to interview people, and took off from there. So anyways, go ahead and tell me a little bit about your life.
Yeah, so I grew up in New Jersey, and I have a brother and a sister. They're younger. And, you know, my father was a salesman. He worked for IZOD. Do you remember those alligators on those shirts?
Yeah,
he worked in New York for them.
Did he? Yeah, he did.
And my mother was a stay-at-home mom. Uh-huh. You know, she was too crazy and stuff. So I grew up in Jersey. I went to high school there, and
now, what part of Jersey is that?
I went to Wall High School, which is in Wall Township, which is right. It's basically the shore. We consider it the
Grand Beaches,
like Manasquan, Belmar. You know,
okay,
Asbury
my grandma
Park.
Was Montclair area, so more near the city.
Well, it was like Fairleigh Dickinson University was up that way, wasn't it? Montclair University.
Montclair, I know, is.
So after high school, I didn't even know what, you know, I wanted to do, you know, because I wasn't. Uh-huh. You know, I sang in a couple like high school bands, which I thought was really fun. I've always kind of been like a ham, I guess you'd say. And
Were you in like plays and stuff in high school?
I wasn't. No, I thought of those people as theater geeks. I was so, you know, I was just kind of like, nah, it's not for me.
That's funny.
Yeah, it is. You know, after high school, I was just so like not knowing what I wanted to do with my life. You got to either go to college or get a job. And I was like, oh, fine. So I got a job at a place called Stearns. Remember Stearns? Like Sears and Stearns.
Yeah.
And like,
yeah.
That kind of thing. And the job was like me waking up at 4 a.m. and driving all the way to this place and unloading trucks.
Oh my God. Soul sucking.
It was hideous. So, you know, after about 6 months of that, I was just like filled with anxiety and I didn't know what to do. So I decided to go to Brookdale Community College in Bancroft, New Jersey. And I had to be full time to keep my health insurance through, you know, my father. And so I decided I didn't want to take marketing. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to try acting 101. So I took it and I loved it. It was like therapeutic, you know, it was therapeutic.
In what way? Describe that.
Just getting up on stage and kind of venting. There was like a little improv beginner's class and just all the stuff inside my head, you know, frustration, and happiness and then anger and all that stuff. I felt it very therapeutic, especially doing it in front of an audience.
You know,
it was nice to get it all out. It was like seeing a shrink, but for free.
And you get it out and you're not like doing any damage.
I'm not doing any damage. That was later in life.
Well, we all hate that.
So then, you know, from there, it was like my thespian friend that I met there, they were all auditioning for bigger colleges, theater programs. And I was like, ooh, so, you know, they were going to Syracuse and NYU and DePaul University in Chicago. And I was like, oh, I got to get in on this. So I went and I auditioned at these kind of repertory theater boot camp schools for actors. And I got accepted to all three, which was like, holy cow, because you do monologues and all stuff.
Did you have to do a monologue for that? Was that the audition process?
Yeah. There's like monologues. And if you made it, like something like 5,000 kids audition for these schools, and they only accept like 110.
Wow. That's great.
It is great.
Yeah.
And I got lucky. And so I chose Chicago because I wanted to move as far away from Jersey as I possibly could.
Well, of course.
Remove myself from the scenario. So I went to Chicago and I went to 2 years at the theater school, DePaul University. I got kicked
out. What years were you there? Because I went to school in the Chicago area too. Well, you're younger than me.
I was there from 92 to 98.
Okay.
So
yeah.
Like 6 years. But I did 2 years there and then they decided to kick me out because I was doing really well in all the acting, but I didn't want to take physics and geometry and all that stuff. So they booted me and I thought my life was over.
Really?
And yeah, I was like, I'll never work. This is horrible. I'll never be an actor. They kicked me out, which was so not true. And I just started doing plays. I was bartending in Charlie's Ale House in Lincoln Park, Chicago. And
wow.
I was doing plays and did that for a while. And then it was time to move again. And I decided I was coming to LA. Jane Alderman was her name. She was a casting director, like probably the biggest casting director in Chicago. And I was friends with her and she liked my work. So she set me up with a meeting with the head of casting at Warner Brothers. And I got cast on ER. I did 2 episodes like within a week.
Oh my goodness.
So it was crazy. So it just kind of, it was just all fast moving and strange, weird. And
yeah. Like you went from like, 0 to 60 and
in a short time. And then, you know, I was testing to be a regular on series and all this stuff. And then you learn a lot about the business and you're like, wait, this isn't theater. This is actual business. Like these people are, they're not as great as you thought they'd be. You know what I mean? So
it's not all one big happy, fairy tale.
No.
Yeah.
So, and then from there, it's just been up and down.
Yeah.
It's just been, you know, good years and bad years and all that stuff, you know.
So you're in the LA area or LA?
I am. Yeah. I'm not in Hollywood. I don't like going into Hollywood. You know, it's very tourist there. You know, it is. So, and, you know, I'll go in there once in a while for my friends doing a show or stand up comedy or something. I'll go in. But for the most part, I'm outside of LA.
So what has been the most challenging part?
Okay. So, I mean, this is, you know, for anything, right? Well.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I just kind of to get the like full picture because I really grill my guests.
Yeah. No, it's fine. No. I would say dark. I mean, in every situation, there's some darkness I've been finding out throughout life.
Definitely agree.
Yeah, and it's, I mean, the business that I'm in, I mean, I don't want to just focus on this business, but it's, it can be real depressing and can be real down, but the highs are so high and the lows are so low. It's kind of like you're walking around in this bipolar brain, you know, in this bipolar world. Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, 1 minute, like I was just, okay, so up until January of this year, I was the voice of Lowe's, right? So I
keep talking about this on your podcast.
Yeah, I did. Okay. I didn't mention them. I'm actually mentioning it now.
Okay, but yeah.
I did. And so for like 6 months,
you were Lowe's.
amazing, like amazing, right? And then all of a sudden they got, you know, a new CEO recently, and he wanted to put his stink on the product. So he said, no more of that guy. We want to hire someone else. And for about a month, I was in the running. So it was between me and one other guy they were looking at. And I was thinking, oh, I got this. I've already done, like, I did like 70 plus tags. I did like a ton of national commercials. And then I got the phone call. Oh, actually, no, this was huge. I go in to do a session at the recording studio and I finish my session. And this woman that I had not heard, it's all patched through. They're in New York and I'm in LA. So it's all patched through headphones in the studio. And this woman comes on. And she's like, hi, Alex. I'm so-and-so. And I'm like, hi, what's going on? She's like, I just want you to know this is going to be your last session. And I'm like,
oh boy.
What? Now, meanwhile, here's the crazy part. The engineers on the other side of the glass are listening to this conversation.
Oh my God.
So it's not just me hearing it.
The
engineers on the other side are looking
at
me.
So everybody is watching you, your like stomach drop.
Yeah. So I just, I walk out, you know, finally I was just like, you know, whatever. And that's fine. I mean, she probably didn't want to have to do that. And I felt for her to have to tell me that. So I walked out.
Well, that's really compassionate of you because that's a tough one.
Well, we'd all, you know, I've had to like let people go before, you know.
Yeah, you're right. Like, no, I know.
And you don't want to do it. No. And I walk out, I walk into the engineer room and the guy's just staring at me. I go, well, I'm going back to bed. Go home.
Got a case of the Mondays.
Yeah. And then, you know, outside of the business, like darkness, I mean, we've all, you know, we have trials and tribulations in our lives. And, you know, my wife had a cancer diagnosis.
Did she?
Years ago. Yeah. And we fought with that for a few years. Then she had an operation and a big major operation to get some tumors out of her stomach. And yeah,
that's rough.
But she's a trooper and she's brilliant and she's doing great. So.
Good to hear. And you know, it's interesting that you're talking about the highs and the lows and the uncertainty and that you've worked with the TS Alliance, because that's like the major challenge with this condition is that you're always getting the rug yanked out from under you because the nature of the care is unpredictable on so many levels. And don't worry, I'm not going to do a whole commercial for TS Alliance or anything.
No, that's fine.
Was drawing that connection, like, because that's exactly it. You know, you have to really kind of ride the waves and there's some real, you know, the good moments, you got to treasure them because there's some real tough times. But that's just really life.
It is life. And, I have the utmost respect for you guys, man. I don't know how you do these things, you know. Okay, so I have a friend, a really good friend of mine. Her daughter is very extreme autistic, right? Very like extreme, like violent autistic. Like, and this girl is now, she's 19, I believe, and she'll never be, she can't hold conversation, she can't focus, and I'm kind of just saying this because of how you guys, I don't know, I have two children. Yeah, my daughter's 19 and my son is 17.
About the same age. Well, I'm more than that. Go ahead. Yeah.
But they're healthy. I'm blessed to have that. I mean, and I look at parents, you know, who deal with their children in this way, you know, and it's, my hat goes off.
Well, you know, I get that and thank you, but it's almost like I don't know what else we would do. You know, I think we just try to do the best we can with how life happen. So,
of course.
Yeah, it's just, you know, it's more extreme. You find your resources and you connect with people that are going through the same thing. And so
it's wild.
It's wild. So, yes, you're married to an actress. How does that work for you guys? Is that a challenge with both your careers? And
you know, it's wild. We talk about this once in a while, not all the time, but once in a while it'll come up. And you know, it's funny, like, last year, the last series I was on was called The Fosters. I did like 10 episodes of it. It was a show on Freeform Channel. And she was kind of doing stuff here and there. And mine was, I guess, I don't know, a little more regular as far as recurring. But she's always managed to just get offers and stuff like that. And now I haven't been on series on camera in about a year. And it's driving me a little crazy.
I bet.
Now she's on Fear the Walking Dead.